Peacefully, joyfully, I am divinely guided. Peacefully, joyfully, I follow my inner guidance.
There's a power within you. It lifts your life to its highest level. It brings success, happiness, health, companionship, and peace of mind. As you tap into this power, it will respond to you because this power is within you. And that's why spirituality rocks. Welcome. I'm your host, Janine Burns. And this week we have a very exciting show for you. Joining me on the sofa in studio is Jodi Fisher of Jodi Ski School. He is a three-time World Cup champion, and Christina Gochin of the Daniel Gill Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. Today our theme is commitment to excellence, and we're going to talk about that in just a minute, but I want you to know what we teach on Spirituality Rocks. We teach new thought principles. New thought, as we saw on a show a few weeks ago, has just pervaded all of culture because it teaches that the power of God, spirit, infinite intelligence, whatever you choose to call the higher power, is an active principle within you and that your thoughts are creative. And so it teaches that your thoughts and attitudes actually affect your life experience. There's a big distinction from New Age. It's not New Age. It is New Thought. So I invite you to check out more about New Thought. And I am an interfaith chaplain. My credentials are held with Emerson Theological Institute. I do a lot of weddings, memorials, I do crisis work, and I love to do inspirational talks. And so today, commitment to excellence. And I have a cute little story for you, commitment to excellence. There were two men waiting in line at a fast food restaurant. And the first one says to the second, "Why is it so hard for people to commit?" And the second man says, "It's primal. It goes way far beyond feeling trapped. It feels like you've quit living and you'd settled into a slow, agonizing, soul-sucking march towards your death." And the first man said, "Whoa, that's a lot to consider when trying to decide on a sandwich for lunch." Today I'm talking about commitment to excellence. Commitment is a non-divertible intention. Your commitment always shows up in the results of your life. You want to see what you're committed to? Look at your life and see what you're experiencing. And of course, excellence is something that's marked by superiority, something that's extraordinary. And so particularly, I want to look at the commitment to doing what it takes to be what you came into life to be and to do what you came into life to do. And there is a quote from the book, A Return to Love by Mary Williamson, that I'd like to read to you. She says that our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we're powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. And your playing small does not serve the world. There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. And it's not just in some of us, it's in every one of us. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. So we've come to life to shine our lights brightly and fully. We are here to be the fullest expression of the universe that expresses through us, the fullest expression that we possibly can. So we are here to be the universe's arms and hands and feet and eyes and mind and heart. We are here to discover our dreams and to live them fully. And we are here to encourage and support and empower others so that they can live their dreams, so that they can shine their lights brightly and discover and live full out in their life experience. And so this is possible for all of us. We can truly come here to be and do whatever we came, as long as we are willing to commit. There's a book entitled The Scottish Himalayan Expedition. It was written by W.H. Murray. And he has this very cool quote, which you've probably heard before. And it starts with him talking about the expedition to the Himalayas. And he said, "But when I said that nothing had been done, I erred in one important matter. We had definitely committed ourselves and were halfway out of our ruts, because they had put down their passage money, booked a sailing boat to Bombay." He said, "This may sound too simple, but it's great in consequence, because until one is committed, there's hesitancy. There's a chance to draw back and always ineffectiveness." And he said that concerning all acts of initiative and creation, there is one elementary truth, the ignorance of which kills countless ideas and splendid plans, that the moment one definitely commits oneself, then providence moves too. A whole stream of events issues from the decision, raising in one's favor all manner of unforeseen incidents and meetings, material assistance, which no man could have dreamt was possible. And he said, "I learned a deep respect for one of Goethe's couplets, whatever you can do or dream you can, begin it." Begin it. You can call forth providence through your power of commitment, and the power of your commitment to be who you were meant to be on earth, what you were meant to do. The challenge with this is discipline. So many people see discipline as something very difficult and unappealing, but discipline is what it takes to follow your dreams and your visions and to be committed to excellence. And if you really face it, a lot of people have challenges disciplining themselves. We don't really like doing it so very much. And I think a lot of people can relate to what Alexander Wilcox said when he said, "All the things I really like to do are either immoral, illegal, or fattening." Yet we have to discipline ourselves. And even though it seems difficult, think about it. It's in the moments that we feel disciplined. It is in those moments that we are empowered. It is those moments that we really feel the best about ourselves. We feel enlivened. We feel on top of it, and we feel in the flow, in the groove of life. Jonathan Swift said, "May you live all the days of your life." That was a quote. And he was inferring with that quote that most people don't live all the days of their life. They're existing. They're just alive. They're walking around, and yeah, they're functioning, but a lot of their time is spent hiding out. A lot of their time is spent avoiding, and a lot of the time is just trying to survive. They're not thriving. They're just surviving, and a lot of it is just getting by and just sort of, some people, you know, just hiding between the sheets. Yet, if we are willing to practice discipline, the whole person that you are suddenly comes forward, the whole person, and then you begin to look at the dimensions of your life that need to be worked on, and you say, "Hey, I need to make some changes here." And then you can empower yourself to get disciplined. I don't care if it's your mind, if it's your emotions, if it's physically, if it's your spirit. That spirit within you will nudge you. Your intuition will guide you and tell you. I've taught many times in this show, our direct inheritance from the universe, our divine ideas. The universe always gives you the ideas that you need to experience your good. And the other one is love. The love is the glue that holds the universe together. It's the energy that draws and attracts and connects us to one another. Now, let's look at how spiritually how we have a commitment to excellence. It's consistently taking time for affirmations and prayer and meditation, studying spiritual principles. Physically, you committed to excellence by paying attention to movement, maybe practicing yoga, you know, diet, sleeping, drinking lots of water. And emotionally, you practice commitment to excellence, by taking time to nourish your spirit, by doing those things that bring a sense of joy, a sense of peace, and a sense of awareness of the beauty in all of creation. And there's so many ways to do that, by being in nature, listening to music, spending quality time with your loved ones, celebrating milestones in your life, birthdays, anniversaries, celebrations, a compliment. There's so many ways. Mentally, we are committed to excellence by using the power of imagination and visualization, by being in charge of our thinking, by focusing on good thoughts and simply discarding negative ones with thought substitution. It can be that easy. An extremely important way to practice commitment to excellence is paying attention to the words that come out of your mouth. If you're not sure what you're committed to, look at your life and it will tell you. And what you're committed to shows up in what you are saying. That's the dead giveaway. What are you talking about? What are you speaking about? Years ago, when I was in seminary training with Dr. Noel McGinnis, he wrote a book called The Power of Commitment. And on page 62 in that book, he said, commitments are initially most evident in our language, especially the language that we use automatically without conscious thought. All words have literal implications, and unconscious use of language tends to perpetuate unwanted experiences. Pay attention to the words that come out of your mouth. Think about it. Our words control us more than we control them. Dr. Ernest Holmes, founder of the philosophy Science of Mind, wrote a book entitled Richer Living, and he said, "The law of mind gives us back our words and form." And this might not always be a pleasant experience. Students should make an honest attempt to control their speech, watch their words, and always say that which is loving and wise, which is not always easy to do. So right now, I'm calling upon you. I am asking you to check yourself. Check yourself when it comes to the words that you speak. Howard Jones. I saw Howard Jones in concert last night. He's one of my, he's my all-time favorite musician. He's a 1980s icon. He's just fantastic, does synthesizer music, and he's a Buddhist. And his songs are always positive. And in the words of Howard Jones, he has a song called Bounce Right Back, and he says, button up and tighten your lip. Keep a check on what you say. Those crazy words you fling from your mouth will bounce back on you someday. And it's true. It's that old goes around, comes around rule. What I want you to know is that you can live your commitment that you came here, whatever you came here to be or to do, to express. Heed the words from Ernest Holmes in his book, This Thing Called You. Let nothing come forth from your lips that you do not wish to see manifest in your life. I want to end with a very exciting idea. When you are committed to excellence, the light that is your light becomes brighter and brighter and brighter. I was just saying that all my friends right now, when I look at them, I see a light that comes out of their light, out of their eyes. And who you are thunders so loudly that people can't even hear what you say. They feel your energy. They feel your essence. And they feel this incredible power that you are just by showing up. So I call upon you to be committed to excellence. Nourish and support and amplify the amazing energy and power of spirit that is within you. Be a light unto the world, which is truly what you are intended to be. And right after our commercial break, I am thrilled that my dear friends, Jodi Fisher, three-time World Cup Tour Championship, is in the studio with us, as well as Christina Goshen of the Daniel Gill Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. So stay tuned. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Peacefully.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act 1 will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
Hey, I'm Tom Mealy from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Like so many people, are your finances tight lately? Afraid to open your mail or even answer your phone? Well, take heart. You don't have to live like that. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you can join the thousands of folks who have used safe and effective government-insured reverse mortgages. The government-insured reverse mortgages from Long Island's Senior Reverse Network allow you to stay in your home and turn equity into tax-free cash. Our government-insured reverse mortgages can eliminate mortgage payments, credit card balances, or just improve your lifestyle. Do yourself a favor and solve these problems now. Call the Senior Reverse Network, and our advisors will answer all of your questions about our reverse mortgage programs. We've helped scores of senior Long Island homeowners like you who now enjoy a worry-free retirement. Get the financial security and peace of mind you've dreamed about. Pick up the phone and call us at the Senior Reverse Network now to set up a free consultation.
Call 1-800-985-REVERSE. That's 1-800-985-7383.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hog's hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Welcome back to Spirituality Rocks. I'm your host, Janine Burns. Thrilled to be in the studio today with dear friends, Jodi Fisher of Jodi's Ski School. He is a three-time World Cup Tour Slalom Ski Champion. Welcome, Jodi.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Fantastic to have you. And Christina Gochin of the Daniel Gale Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. Welcome back, Christina.
Thank you for having me, Janine.
You know, I'm excited. Last year, both Christina and I went skiing with Jodi. And Christina and I, neither of us thought that we were going to be able to get back up on our back up on skis, although I had done it as years and years ago, as well as Christina. And we were so inspired by Jodi, by his encouragement, his support, by the light in his eye. And it was so fantastic. Tell him about it.
Well, of course, I started skiing. I did not ski when I was younger. I'm from the Midwest, and we don't go on boats. So it was going to be me, and it was going to be getting towed all over the Long Island Sound until I finally got up on the skis. I was very pessimistic about it, but always willing to do anything for a good laugh. So after Jodi's probably third or fourth tweaking of my, I guess we would call it my posture and style, I got up on the skis and I was thrilled. I was absolutely amazed. But yeah, he used the right words for me.
He was encouraging.
And the words taught me. The words did.
Yeah, I agree.
And your body follows.
I was able to get up after a couple of tries too. And then I remember when I used to jump the waves and stuff. And so then I started doing that and I went right down. But it was so much fun. It was so much fun. So Jodi, tell us, when did you know, because it takes discipline, it takes commitment, when did you know that you were committed and this was going to be your life?
It's an interesting way it happened. My parents water skied for many years. It was their chosen sport. They used to go down to the river, River Trent, near Nottingham. And I was...
Nottingham, England.
Nottingham, England. And I was, you know, so young, I didn't really have a choice in it as far as we were there every weekend. But pretty soon I got the opportunity to try on my birthday at the age 7. And I absolutely loved it. And, you know, 3 or 4 years later, the World Championships came to England. They're in London. And, of course, if you do a sport to that degree, you know, we wanted to go watch the world's best water skiers. So I was taken down to London. The weather was amazing. And I watched two British guys, Andy Mapple and Mike Hazelwood, both win world titles.
Wow.
And at age 11, sat on that shore, I decided that's what I wanted to do.
At age 11?
At age 11.
Wow. In my opening, I talked about discipline. Tell us about the discipline required to do what you do.
Well, I was fortunate to be in a position where my parents were supportive of it. Of course, they already had a boat and were prepared to take me on the weekends. Once I started to get into it more and more, they were there to encourage that and to take me. Obviously, until I was of the age where I could drive, I was reliant on them.
Mm-hmm.
And other ski friends that we socialized with and water skied with. Just an amazing opportunity. I felt very blessed and very lucky to be in that position.
So the discipline came from your desire, the vision that you had?
Yeah, and also I felt it was the way I had to pay back how I was given that opportunity. If I was going to be given that opportunity to do it on a regular basis, I needed to be serious and disciplined about it.
I see.
It's very interesting. I wonder if we have these discussions all the time, but that internal drive, that internal discipline, is that something that's genetic, or is it something that your parents taught you, being very, very driven and disciplined themselves?
I think it's probably a bit of both. I mean, you know, I obviously was attracted to the sport physically, and the emotions of
right.
speed and the challenge of being able to control all of the different things that it takes. I mean,
right.
there's different forces. There's a mental side of it of dealing with how to deal with the different conditions and so on. It's a very challenging sport in many ways, mentally
Absolutely.
As well as physically.
Yeah, and that's what I was thinking about. But I think it's our nature. I think we came to life with gifts and talents, and that's where we shine our light. And so I think it's also innate. There's that within you that seeks. And when you catch a vision and you catch a dream, then the discipline will generally follow. Even if it is an incredibly difficult sport. And, you know, even if you go through challenges and broken bones or whatever, to just get right back out there and do it. And what I'm very excited about is that we have a clip of Jodi. Can you lead us into this clip that we have? It's just a couple of minutes long of you skiing.
I think it's a combination of the various different elements of the sport with slalom, tricks, and jump. I believe it's from one of the World Cup
starts
that I competed in Dubna in Russia.
Is that one of the ones that you won?
It is, yes.
Okay.
Well, it was one of the ones for the tour season.
I see.
You know, it's very, very similar to the Grand Prix points that you would collect, ending up with a champion at the end of the season.
Okay, I wasn't aware of that. Okay, great.
Yeah, so...
Is this the award-winning footage? Is this where you brought home the trophy?
You know, I believe it might be.
All right, good. Well, let's take a look. Let's check it out.
So moving on to some of the action that's already taken place here in Dubna, and a great performance from the young Canadian Whitney McClintock on her debut World Cup tour stop. And joining her in the finals off the back of this superb opening run was Karina Nolan of Australia.
You know, this year, 2008, women's slalom's just been absolutely insane. When you're standing on the dock with the top 10 women's slalomers in the world, nothing's ever easy. I can't really go out with one name, it's Emma and Karen and all those girls, but there's also, you know, Nicole and Whitney and all these young girls coming up, and it makes it really, really hard to go out there and beat them.
You UK's Sarah Green failed to make the cut. A former world champion in jump and slalom, Emma Shears of Australia, also found the conditions a little unforgiving. Reigning world champion Thomas De Gasperi of Italy secured a place in the final, but unfortunately Nick Parsons of the US failed to make the grade. With a lot of new talent starting to emerge, we caught up with two of the most experienced riders on the tour to ask whether age really mattered.
I'm 38 now, and I've been at this a long time. You know, there's the old guard. There's guys like Jodi and I and Glenn Campbell, who have been at it for a lot of years. And then there are new faces. There's number one Will Asher, who's out there, and Thomas De Gasperi, the world champ. And these guys are 10 years younger than me anyway. It just gets harder every year and makes training through the winter that much more disciplined and having a lot of fun with it.
It's great to be part of it still. I'm here to have a go for the title again. But there's a lot of up-and-coming talent that's surely knocking on the door.
Well, it's time now to head out on the water for the women's slalom finals with our commentator, Des Burke-Kennedy.
Thank you, Russell. Here she comes, the first lady on the water, Clémentine Lucine from France, kicking off on the 14-2-5 line. She'd regard this as a long line. She should run this with her eyes closed. It's a little choppy out there. We're hoping the wind doesn't pick up, but here she is now making this look oh so easy, gathering up the slack and out the end gate. That's a great 14-2-5. She also clears the 13-meter line, coming in now on the 12-meter line. Let's see if she can get a big score on this one. She'll need a good gate. There she's got the gate. Lining up a little late on number one. She's really struggling for point number two. Oh, there's a big surprise, Clémentine Lucine, that world overall champion, having to settle for two boys on the 12-meter line. Second off the dock, ranked number two in the world, Karen Trula from the United States. As we can see, it is a bit choppy out there, this 14-2-5 line being a little more challenging than these ladies would expect. You can see that ski bobbling along there. It's a slightly tail breeze, but out that end pass, she'll breathe a sigh of relief now and come back. No, she's going to skip the next shortening. She's going to go straight to the 12-meter line. Now she's got to run this entire pass to score. She's got around one, heading towards two. She's very late on two. Oh, that's a big problem for Karen Trulove. Officially, she will only score 1.5 boys on the 13-meter line. Now, the youngest of all, Whitney McClintock from Canada, coming in on the 14-2-5. Long, tall lady here. Look at this beautiful reach. First time in Russia, first time in a World Cup series. No sign of nerves whatsoever. What a performance from this youngster. Is this going to be her year? Wow, can you imagine taking on the big guns today? Coming back now on the 12-meter line to take the lead. She's got to get anything better than two boys on this pass. She's got around boy one and she's looking very good on one. Well lined up for two, under no pressure whatsoever in this choppy water. She's got three. She could make it out to four. Oh yes, she is going to score four. No wonder she's happy. Now Karina Nolan already has the 14 under her belt. She's got to clear the 13 meter line now to get a crack at taking the lead on the subsequent one. Okay, she needs a clear pass here. It should be quite easy for her. No, it's not. She's struggling. She's playing catch up right now. Here she is around boy five. Oh, she did not clear the pass. That gives the title to Whitney McClintock from Canada. Here comes the attorney from Toronto in Canada. No surprises here, I would think. This is his 12-meter pass. He's got a half meter of spare line to get around each one of those six boys. Look at his upper body position. Cool, calm, and collected. Around boy six and out the end gate. So now, can he get anything beyond 1.5 on this pass to take the lead? Okay, through the gates and around boy one. He looks very good on one. That's a great one. He's got around two, looking good as he approaches the halfway. This is around boy three. Oh, he's struggling. Drew Ross is going to have to settle for three, but it is a good score. You can see it. Body language tells us he is happy. Now, who have we got here? Jodi Fisher, the veteran. This guy has a personal best of three boys on the 10.75. Out around boy one. Here he comes on the 12-meter pass. Again, looking very strong. Years of experience. Is experience going to win over age on this fifth visit to the Dubna World Cup stop? Well, oh, this is the way to do it. Jody's settling down there. He doesn't even look like he's breathing heavily. Now the challenge is on. He's going to have to dig deep. This is the 11-2-5 line. He knows Drew Ross has three on the this shortening. Can he get anything beyond boy three? Through the gate, waiting for boy one. A lovely boy one on the 11-2-5. He's got two on the 11-2-5. Here he is equaling Drew Ross's score. Oh, we have a tie. Will we have a runoff later on? He looks a little angry with himself. I think he thought he could have got a little more, but that's a good score. Now, can Jean-Baptiste Facy from France do any better? His personal best is on the 10-2-5 line. So surely this 11-2-5 line has to be... No, it's not an easy one for him. He's really struggling. Now, surprise, surprise, he's going to have to settle for two boys on the 11-2-5. He's not going to be first or second place with that one. Well, Thomas de Gasperi, world slalom champion, 12-meter pass. This should be easy peasy for him. Oh, can you believe it? It's one surprise after another. You can see Thomas de Gasperi just totally losing body position on boy one.
Skier jump to 11.
Did we hear that? He's jumping to the 11-meter line. He's got to clear this entire pass to get a score. Otherwise, he'll score on the previous pass. This is all or nothing. What a gamble. 11-2-5. He scored one. He scored two on the 11-2-5. Now he's coming up to the halfway point. He's got three on the 11-2-5. Oh, he's looking good. He's going to run this. Or is he running into trouble? Around five. No, he won't score five. In fact, he won't score the pass. Tragedy for Will Asher. 4.5 on the 12. So it's a runoff between this man here, Drew Ross, and Jodi Fisher. Here comes Drew Ross on the 12-meter pass. And Drew settling for three on the 12. Oh, can Jodi Fisher take the title? 12-meter pass, anything beyond three, and he will do it. He's got one. Experience, will it win today? He's got two. Will experience win? He's got three. Come on, Jodi, anything better than three? And he has done it. A half boy made the difference. One happy slalom skier.
Drew and I think, are the two oldest skiers here on tour this weekend. So, you know, he's got a lot of experience. He's one of the taller guys also. So I knew it would be tough. But came my way in the runoff.
Well, absolutely excellent the results there for both Whitney McClintock and Jodi Fisher as they lift honours in the slalom.
Woo! Yay! Jodi Fisher! All right, Jodi!
That was exciting. You saw those girls. Those girls, that was Janine and I after like one lesson, right?
Jodi's fantastic. Right. Speaking of which, Jodi's going to be around. He's giving lessons in Cold Spring Harbor. If you'd like lessons the last week in August, Jodi, tell them your phone number.
407-970-5941.
You can send him a text one more time.
407-970-5941.
Fantastic. All righty. So... It's time for a commercial break. Come right back and join us. We are going to talk more about with Jodi and Christina about 69 Slam and the Spray It Forward Foundation and what's going on with both of them. So we'll be right back with Spirituality Rocks.
Peacefully, joyfully, I am divinely guided. Peacefully, joyfully, I follow my inner guidance. Peacefully, joyfully, I am divine.
I think this is a good time to tell you. You're doing okay, Mom. I can call you Mom, right? I know we haven't known each other very long, but you seem like a real keeper. You're not perfect. There was that strained carrots incident, but you're trying. You pick up my bottle every time I toss it out of my stroller. That's high comedy to an 8-month-old. You hum the Barber of Seville when you wash my hair. So cool. And your rubdowns are out of this world. Anyway, I want you to know how much I appreciate you. You know, right? How much I love you? You're doing okay, Mom.
Hey, I'm Tom Mealy from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Back to Spirituality Rocks. I'm your host, Janine Burns. Thrilled to be here in the studio with Jodi Fisher, three-time World Cup Tour slalom champion. Woohoo! That
thank
video
you,
we saw
you.
Was outstanding. And Christina Gochin of the Daniel Gale Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. So, we just offered you the opportunity, if you're interested in taking lessons with Jodi this coming week. Tell us your phone number again, Jodi.
407-970-5941.
And I'd like to speak about that because I am currently and have been a patient. Please.
A student.
A student of Jodi's. I also have all three of my kids taking lessons as well, and the kids really take to it so quickly. But I cannot say enough about how great it is, even if you ski, to get a lesson to kind of up your game a little bit.
Absolutely.
I know a lot of the ski team.
We've had seven children this week.
Seven children.
That
fantastic.
Have been introduced to it, and they've all come out with a huge smile.
And also adults, and you teach all, what's your age range of people that you teach?
It's, you know, anything from, I don't know, 4 to 80.
4 to 80, because yeah. I know you have some students right now who are like 60s, 70s that you're teaching right now. Yeah. That's fantastic. And Christina, I also would like to tell the people also information about you. Now, if you want to check out Jodi's website, it's Jodi Ski School. That's Jodi School, SCHOOL, .com, JodiSkiSchool.com. And Christina, what I love about Christina is she matches people with her home. She's a real estate agent with the very prestigious Daniel Gale Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. How can we get in touch with you?
That's right, Janine. You can text me at 917-837-1114. It's the easiest way because I'm usually busy and not at a desk.
Okay, fantastic. And I want you to know that if you want to get in touch with me, you saw my websites across the screen, youarethelight.org, ilovetodoweddings.com. And you also, if you're interested in my CD, Tunes for Transformation, you hear the music during the breaks in the commercial, we can send that to you. You can write us at Post Office Box 472. That's in Woodbury, New York, Post Office Box 472. And if you send us a self-addressed stamped envelope, we're happy to send you more information about commitment to excellence. So, one of the exciting things I love about you, Jodi, is that you are a visionary, that you have big dreams and goals in mind, and that gets me very excited. And one of the things is your product line of swimwear and underwear, and it's called 69 Slam.
69 Slam.
And I am holding what is mine called?
That one's Summer. Called Summer.
This is my bathing suit here. This men's bathing suit is Summer. And if you could get a close-up on it, you would see that it has like flip-flops on it and sunglasses. They're absolutely fabulous. And how can people buy this product? Where do they go on the web?
You go to www.69slam.com.
www.69slam.com. And Christina, let's see what you've got there.
Oh, these are so great. And what I love about the line is it's really fashion forward and a little cheeky. So this is called Eve's Leaves, and I don't know if you can get a really tight shot on it. I know this is probably a G-rated show, but this is really cool. And I think for the target market, this is an excellent, it's awesome. People will be asking you about your shorts all the time.
Oh, absolutely. And the colors are beautiful. And also, yeah. I noticed the material is sensational.
Oh. Yeah.
And, you know, I love clothes. I'm not even sure what this lining is, but it's fantastic. And I understand that it dries off pretty quickly, too.
It really does. And we've gotten a lot of awards for having the best sublimation printing. I mean, the actual quality is very, I mean, it's photo quality printing.
Yeah.
And it wears really well, washes really well, and mm-hmm. does not fade. So it's a really quality product at a good price point.
At a good price point, great. And what, this particular short is called what?
That's our medium length, which is...
And the style?
The style.
Is the Adventurer?
Aquarium.
Aquarium.
Aquarium is the print.
Oh, yes.
It's the medium length, which would, for most guys, finish just above the knee. It's an 18-inch inseam.
Right.
Then we have our typical 21. Actually, this is the 21-inch.
Okay, the long, which is very popular.
The skiers
see the guys.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. The skiers. We see them walking like around town in that. Yeah.
And what else is really terrific is you can buy swimwear for the whole family, and it matches. So some of the bathing suits here to the right, these are ladies' suits. Some of the prints are also available for children as well. And the prints that you see are also prints for the underwear line as well, no?
Correct, yeah.
I love the one on the left that has the anchors on it. It's really
anchors are very big this season, this I can tell you.
Yeah, and I understand the fit on these is absolutely fantastic, and the designs are just beautiful. The colors are strong and true.
That's actually a sneak peek at next year's spring-summer collection.
Oh, so that's the spring-summer collection of next year. Yeah. Fantastic.
So it's really interesting. It's fun to me. You know, I wanted to take on, I try and keep very busy, as you know. You know, I have a water ski school. I have a daughter that keeps me very busy. You know, I've been a professional water skier for a long time. So between training and coaching, I love to coach and teach. And I've always been into fashion and style and wanting to be able to bring a brand like this. You know, for me, it was a challenge. I had the opportunity to bring a brand into the U.S.
Yes.
And the U.S. is known as the market. You know, in the Western world, the U.S. is the big market. So to be able to have that challenge of bringing an unknown brand into the U.S. and challenge some of the bigger surf brands out there, it was a really interesting challenge for me to get involved in.
So how do you stay focused? How do you stay determined? How do you stay committed? Do you have any particular techniques? Like on the show, we talk a lot about affirmations and meditation and affirmative prayer. I know you're out in nature all the time, so you're nourishing your spirit for sure. But are there any particular techniques that you use?
I don't know. I'm open-minded enough, or I feel open-minded enough to be able to draw from other people's knowledge and experience, and just know that I'm here to learn. It's an industry that I didn't know too much about. And I had to, if you like, take a crash course in it. And I'm learning all the time. And especially with technology changing so quickly with the internet and websites and the way people purchase product these days, it's been great fun.
So you've had to stay on top of it.
Mm.
Well, what's really interesting too is when Jodi was coaching my kids, and I think any kids, you have to ask the kids to place their endurance before the pain. So it's going to hurt. Trust me. I hurt for
muscles
probably
get sore
two to 3 days, maybe weeks after. But you have to teach the kids that even though it's painful and it's an arduous process to learn with water coming out of everywhere for weeks, if that's how long it takes someone to get up. But you push through that and endure that to get to the bonus at the end. And you have to be able to endure the pain.
And that's why commitment, and the commitment is a non-divertible intention. So you're committed to doing it. I recall we had a conversation a while back about visualization.
Yes.
You were just training a young man named Nate. Tell us about Nate, how his success, and talk to us about the visualization.
Yeah, well, Nate Kiley from Connecticut, he started competing only a year ago.
How old is he?
He's 14 and a half,
okay.
Nearly 15. And he did extremely well last year. In fact, within his first year, he made it to the national championship. This year was always going to be a challenge because he went from boys 2 to boys 3, which put him into the age category of 14 to 17. So he goes in at the bottom, of course. He's, at the age of 14, quite a lot smaller than the guys who are 15 and 16 and 17.
Okay.
So, and he also had to go up to the maximum speed of 36 miles an hour.
Oh, wow.
So being...
Oof. That's fast.
It is. And he did extremely well at the regional championships and finished in the top 5, which gets you an automatic invite to the national championships. On paper, he really wasn't capable of making the nationals this year, we didn't think. He performed his personal best and actually did that.
And made it to the nationals.
And made it to the nationals.
And so, yes, because I know you did... tell me that you were talking to him about visualization.
Well, we had to use that because he took a couple of crashes, and as you said,
he hurt seriously. It hurts.
He had a bit of a knee twist and,
okay.
And an ankle twist,
right.
Which kept him off the water for a few days.
Okay.
And you know, it's a technique that I was taught that you can really double your time. That, you know, water skiing is one of those sports where you can only do so much. You know, it's very physical sport. It's not like you can play tennis for 3 hours,
right.
Or go out on a soccer field and kick a ball for endless.
Only be on the ski so much.
Yeah, you know,
it's a 90-second experience,
right.
For most of us.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So very physical.
And so you because creative visualization is an incredible tool in terms of practical spirituality and New Thought teachings. We are taught to use the power of your mind, and you know, most people say, well, you know, I'll believe it when I see it. Where New Thought teaches that when you see it. And then you believe it, and then you'll have it, so
right.
That you need to have a vision. So you actually had him imagine himself. Tell us the process.
Very much so. Well, I mean, it takes practice to be able to, you know, lie there on your bed, and you can do it many different ways. You either close your eyes and imagine yourself seeing what you would see when you're doing
okay.
It. Or you have that out-of-body experience and you put yourself watching that person,
mm-hmm.
As if you're watching somebody else from
the
distance.
We call it witness.
Correct.
It's called witnessing, right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you witness yourself almost as if you're watching a movie.
Correct.
Yeah.
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 And you should be able to match exactly the time that it would take to go through a slalom course at 36 miles an hour is 16.08 seconds.
Oh, wow.
but and you're over that distance, you're traveling
right.
800 feet. So there's six turns.
That is insane. I love it.
Yeah, and you're accelerating up to speeds of
right.
close to 70 miles
right.
an hour. And there's quick deceleration down to 10 miles an hour. So it's faster than any motorcycle can accelerate.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
There's 3 to 4...
faster than a motorcycle can accelerate.
Yeah,
three or four G's.
So it's really quite incredible the forces that you can learn to control.
Right. Do you use affirmations? Do you give Nate an affirmation? Do you tell him to while he's visualization to think that you know I'm doing my best and I'm strong?
Most definitely. I mean, you know, there's a lot of things when you're competing that you cannot control.
Right.
Of course, if you go to an event and there's first of all, you have an unusual sight.
Okay.
Although the slalom course, the dimensions of the slalom course are exactly the same. You know, the shoreline looks different. It's possibly a different boat, a different boat crew. So there's things that can detract.
Variables that can detract. Okay.
And break your concentration. So you have to, in a way, in training, put yourself in a competitive mindset. And bring your emotions and your excitement up to what you would feel in an event, because it's very hard to calm yourself down in an event. You have to learn to bring yourself up in training. That's an easier way to control it. A crowd on the shore, commentary, things like this
right.
That you cannot control. They're going to be there anyway.
So then you then teach him self-talk skills.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay, that's so fantastic. Yes. That's right along with New Thought and Practical Spirituality, because as you change your thinking, your life changes, and that too takes discipline. And as I said before, that discipline seems stinky because we don't think we like it, but when we are disciplined, that's when we're so empowered and so alive, because we have made a commitment. We have that non-divertible intention, and that's when our light shines so brightly. Yeah, that's some exciting stuff. We will be right back after our last commercial break, and we're going to talk about Spray It Forward, Jodi's foundation. So join us in just a few moments with Jodi Fisher and Christina Gochin on Spirituality Rocks.
Peacefully, joyfully, I am divinely guided. Peacefully, joyfully, I follow my inner guidance. Peacefully, joyfully.
When your cable's on the fritz, you get frustrated. When you get frustrated, your daughter imitates. When your daughter imitates, she gets thrown out of school. When she gets thrown out of school, she meets undesirables. When she meets undesirables, she ties the knot with undesirables. And when she ties the knot with undesirables, you get a grandson with a dog collar. Don't have a grandson with a dog collar. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. When your cable company keeps you on hold, you get angry. When you get angry, you go blow off steam. When you go blow off steam, accidents happen. When accidents happen, you get an eye patch. When you get an eye patch, people think you're tough. When people think you're tough, people want to see how tough. And when people want to see how tough, you wake up in a roadside ditch. Don't wake up in a roadside ditch. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. When you pay too much for cable, you throw things. When you throw things, people think you have anger issues. When people think you have anger issues, your schedule clears up. When your schedule clears up, you grow a scraggly beard. When you grow a scraggly beard, you start taking in stray animals. And when you start taking in stray animals, you can't stop taking in stray animals. Stop taking in stray animals. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act 1 will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
Peacefully, joyfully, I am divinely guided. Peacefully, joyfully, I follow.
Welcome back to Spirituality Rocks. I'm your host, Janine Burns, in the studio today, live, Deer Park, Long Island, at Madhouse Studios with Jodi Fisher, who is a three-time World Cup Tour slalom champion, and Christina Gochin of the Daniel Gale Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. Each week on the show, I like to do an affirmative prayer. I like to do it in the first person so you can resonate in your own consciousness and be empowered. So now's the time that we do that. So I just invite you to just get still. You can breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth. Do that a couple of times. And I invite you to flow with these words. The energy and power of spirit pervades all of life everywhere, and this power expresses in me, through me, and as me. I am committed to excellence. I'm always in the right place at the right time, doing the right thing, and divine opportunities are all around me. My mind is alert, my heart is open wide, and I accept these opportunities, whatever they may be, for the particular good that I choose to experience. I move forward in life with freedom and ease and peace and joy. And I release this prayer with an attitude of gratitude, knowing all is in divine order in my life and affairs, and so it is. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wow. This is the 69 Slam catalog. You can check out the website at www.69slam, that's 69slam.com, to find out more about the products that we showed earlier in the show. And Christina, how can the people get in contact with you?
Daniel Gill Agency in Cold Spring Harbor. You can email me at christinagochin@danielgill.com, or best, just text out to me at 917-837-1114.
And if you want to take skiing lessons, water skiing lessons with our pro over here, our resident teacher pro, Jodi, tell the people your phone number, please.
407-970-5941.
Again, it's 407-970-5941. All righty then. I'm very excited about a couple of things. First of all, this water ski is fantastic. I just want to jump up on the table and put it on. Tell us, is this your Tours Cup winner,
well,
of Slalom Ski?
Bizarrely enough, I was telling you about that story at
yes.
the beginning. Andy Mapple, we became training partners for 11 years.
You're kidding?
No. So,
oh.
You know, back in, I made it into the British team. We ended up meeting. He was... is 8 years older than I, so for me to be able to be introduced to a sport, be looking up to the world's best, and
yeah.
then all of a sudden
wow,
starting to rub shoulders with them, and,
yeah.
and I ended up becoming his training partner for
wow.
11 years until he retired. Well, he now has a water ski company.
Oh.
And he sponsors me, and this is his first product of the year, of the company, which he launched last year. So this is a Mapple 6.0, and we've worked together with, you know, the different products. He's helped me with 69 Slam. I've sponsored him. He went to the World Senior
oh,
Championships in Mexico last year when he won.
Okay.
And I'm helping him with his company.
Awesome.
Or just look at this. And these are sponsors that you have, that
the Mastercraft Boat Company.
Right.
And then of course 69 Slam. So you know, I think in today's world, the synergy of being able to cross-promote is very important. And we try and bring our brands and our association in line with each other so that we can help each other.
And, you know, that's a natural spiritual principle. When you do get disciplined and you stay committed to your dream, your vision, and goal, you naturally, synchronistically draw people, circumstances, and events into your life to help you. For instance, Jodi is underway is his... not-for-profit called Spray It Forward. And when I heard about what Jodi was doing, I have experience with not-for-profit, and I've done it a few times to actually help create them. And so I offered to help Jodi with it. And it's
Thank
going along, my pleasure, it's going along swimmingly. We are underway, and it's so exciting. Tell people about it. Don't you love the name? Spray It Forward, S-P-R-A-Y, Spray It Forward. Tell the people about Spray It Forward.
Well, Spray It Forward really came about... In 2010, I started on the road. I took my ski school on the road with a tour bus and towing a boat, and being able to promote the water ski school and teach as many people as possible within that summer period. And I was actually invited to a number of collegiate water ski events, especially in the Midwest.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, a lot of people get introduced.
Right, we have 2 minutes, so.
Okay, a lot of people get introduced to the sport at college, and I went to these events, and it was just very apparent that they you know, they're on a budget, they had limited equipment, and very little of it, and what the equipment they had was fairly old.
Right.
The industry's come a long way, new materials, new manufacturing processes.
Safer.
You can see here with the hard shell binding, we've got carbon fiber mm-hmm. materials. So I wanted to do something about that. We actually donated a ski of that time, and the most needy team, there was 20 kids sharing one ski.
Wow.
So actually, when we picked the name out of a hat, it happened to be Indiana State University. They won this extra ski. Now they've got two. So it became apparent to me that all of these water skiers around the world, they update their equipment very regularly, and there's a lot of equipment sitting in people's garages.
And so I happen to know that you are collecting gently used skis that are sitting in people's closets, as well as donations to support college teams, introduce people to the sport, and
you
help
can
those.
Write it off fully, right?
Yeah, you know, it's yeah. Well, yeah, yes, the not-for-profit status is pending right now. So it's pretty exciting. Spray It Forward.
Spray It Forward.
Spray
and
it
the
forward.
Idea is that we're going to work with the National Water Ski the Association, the NCWSA, the National Collegiate Water Ski Association for them to administrate handing these skis back out to the school.
To the school. It's awesome. Great. I love your vision. Alrighty then. Next week, my guest is Ellen Kratka. She is a healing code practitioner of the healing codes. If you've not read that book, it's a fantastic book by Dr. Alex Lloyd. She also teaches the Yun method. So I invite you to tune in live next week at 6 p.m. for Spirituality Rocks. And don't forget, Monday nights, my favorite show is with Tommy Moore. He just had on 10 years after, and he's got a lot of great things coming up. So thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you.
Jodi Fisher, Christina Gosha. I just think you guys are the greatest. I love this idea of discipline and commitment to excellence. And we'll see you next week on Spirituality Rocks.